We're here this morning, afternoon, to tell you about an upcoming production by Sami's Media. It has a working title of Red Carpet, and it's being produced by our very own sister here. Sami's Media is coming up with a new production called Red Carpet. And at this point, I'd like to call upon the director of the movie to tell us a little bit about it.
Story of the script for the reason we're gathered here. I want my producer to tell us the reason for this gathering and the reason she's made up her mind to make this project. Once she's able to define the reason we're all gathered here and the reason we are set to make this project, then I can talk about this. I hope we're not offended by this. If we are not offended, thank you very much.
Good afternoon, everybody, and I'm really sorry for starting this program in so much time. Some of the journalists have changed their time to be interested. There's nothing I can do about that. So, first of all, I'd like to say that Sami's Media has been around for the past 15, 14 years. And then we've done our first movie was in 2005, and I worked with Frank Raja. That was the first movie in Ghana at the time. And it was a hit, it did well. We went to Nigeria, we saw that was the time Ghanaian movies could go far. That was the beginning of the movies we had done together. So I talk of this script. I got this script I think 8 or 7 years ago. I had this idea, I had the script writer, that was what I want. I want something that has never been told in Africa before. Something that we something about ourselves, the filmmakers ourselves. This script has to do with filmmaking itself in Germany. Artists, whatever goes on, directors, props people, people behind the scenes that we never see. So I decided that, okay, if I want to do this, I need a high budget, yeah, first of all. I need timing, I need to take my time, put this together well. So it took me a long time, yes. A lot of people thought I wouldn't shoot it. But now I'm ready. Called Frank. Few people we have worked with in years who are doing really good at their jobs. And we are ready to go on. So on this note, I'll give the mic to Frank. He will continue to talk about other things. So Sami's Media is here to stay. And after this, there will be more to come by his grace.
I hope he's appreciated. I'm sitting here again with Samira some years back, and precisely about, let's say 11, 12 years ago. I also had a deal like this with Samira, and that was my very first project in Ghana. Was titled Official Prostitute with a blessed memory, late Susie Williams. Obviously, she's not going to be in this project right now because she's normal. We meet her, we know that today now she would have been one of the best providers most celebrated, you know, that would have been for this season, I mean, in this period, but it's unfortunate, and she's not here with us. For this project we're about to start, let's just go straight to the point. We're all aware, we all understand what it means, that behind the smiling face that gleams in the glance of every celebrity you see on the red carpet or wherever, there is a story. The story might not be the best of it. The story might not be as glam as you might see it. The story might be that of sadness, sour memories. You know, that is what the story is about. It is not everyone you see on the street or every celebrity you see riding on the best of cars, living in mansions and being celebrated by everyone on the street and the rest of the world. You see every smile, you see a celebrity walk on the red carpet, you see her waving and smiling and all of that, and we all aspire to want to be like them. We dream, our visions, our desires, our drive to want to be like them. It is not every celebrity you see smiling on the red carpet that you wish to want to be like. There's a story behind everything or everyone seated there. You want to be like Abdusalam Umuni. I'm sure if Salam sits you down to tell you his story and what he's going through, you might not want to be like him. You want to be like Jackie Appiah. We've seen luxurious cars posted on our social media. We've seen loads of it. We've seen her living and flying everywhere like Sandra Ancobia. But we all desire to want to be like these people, but they all have stories behind their face, behind the smiling face you see, their stories. There are positive and negative stories in all of these things. The story here, Red Carpet, is here to enlighten and teach us what it means to be a star. That the journey of stardom is not a weak one. It is not for the weak, it's for the strong. It's for those who are willing, who's got the drive. But then again, you be careful who you want to aspire to be or what you want to aspire to. You want to be a star? Careful. You just never know the do's and the don'ts in the world. So, right about now, that's just about a quick introduction to what it is. If you have any questions you want to ask, whether me or my colleagues that are seated here, if you have any question for us, feel free to ask us questions and we're ready to give you answers. Thank you.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, Pastor. I can't wait to watch this movie myself. But before we get into the questions and answers segment, I'd like to introduce the rest of the people on the high table here. Before I even introduce to Samira, I have to be the producer of this movie. Seated next door is Fat Raja, who just spoke, and he is the director or will be the director for the movie. Next to him is the lovely Jackie Andrea. She is starring in the movie as well. And right next to her is Father Kalsum Sinari Bakhu. She will be in the movie as well. And then Papi Damfu is also in the movie. And Kalista Okoroko is also in the movie. Right, and before we get into the questions and answer segments, let me just acknowledge a few people in our office today.
Some of them were able to succeed, I mean, make it big time. Some of them were still good, but were not able to have been that bright like others. So this time we're set to making sure that every cast we pick from tomorrow becomes what we pray we wish them to become. But looking at some good acting, beautiful acting, good diction, articulation, characters that are willing, that's got the drive to stand the taste of time, those are the characters for tomorrow. So whatever it is, we know that most of them might have place in this grade. Some of them might not have place in this grade, but will have place in subsequent jobs. So tomorrow, picking out every character we want to focus on for the period of time we're set to fill out. Thank you.
Thank you. Please, my friend. Would you mind telling us the budget for the movie? Are you comfortable?
Well, the budget is big, but I'm not going to say how much, because we're still on. It's not easy, but we've gotten some. People are trying to help you help us. So people like this hotel, they are giving out this place for free. The auditioning here is for free. Nobody's buying a form, nobody's paying for the auditioning. It's free. You're coming to audition. If you're good, you'll be. If you're not, you go with us. So people keep calling and asking. People are people put up on Instagram and people are asking, are we going to pay something? Because people pay for auditioning, or you're buying a form. No, you're not buying a form. You are not paying for nothing. You're coming to audition. If you're good, you'll be. If you're not, you go with.
Anyway, I know that because we've been having some little Twitter on the budget, you know. For me, it's very easy for me to open my mouth and say, we need this, we need that, okay? And the producer will also check a pocket and be able to say, oh, this is too much and we need to cut this down. In place of this private jet, we need probably Jack one of Jackie's car. You understand? But you see, but it is not to say, when you say budget, I know she wouldn't want to say, but tentatively right now, we're having a budget of about $180,000. We pray that at the end of the day we get support from people to cut down, but it's not to say that we're not going to budget for everything. If this place is given to us for free, it's not to say that it shouldn't be budgeted or accounted for. So the budget for it has to be put part of the budget for the film. If Jackie is saying to Samira, because you've been managing me for some years now and I appreciate the job you've done, as far as my career is concerned, instead of taking that, I'm probably asking for my fee, I'll probably make it 50% of my fee. It's not to say the budget has been made for. It has to be made for. So if we put all of these together, including Abdul Salam saying, okay, Samira, I can give you some of my equipment to support the shoot. It's not to say we can't make put the budget for the equipment. All of these things has to come in place, and we need to put all of these things together. So if we put all of this together, I'm sure we'll have over $180,000. So it's not a simple shoot, it's not an easy one, but I'm sure by the end of the day, we'll all be happy with the kind of, or rather the class of shoot we're set to make. Thank you.
You're in a movie. I'm sure you've read the script. You probably know your character. How excited are you?
I'm extremely excited. I've been wondering for the past, God knows how many years, what I want you to recommend. It's a very beautiful story that the world needs to know. She's had for a very long time. So finally, the day's here, and I'm excited to be a part of this. It's going to be history. I'm excited to be part of history. Recovered. Frank said everything. Tell us about our house. If somebody wants to be someone and then it's a whole lot that goes on behind the scenes that people don't know about. So when you're going to tell this story to let people know that there's more to just what you see in the screen. So Rebecca Bates is here to stay.
Kind of careful what you wish for or who you wish to be.
Okay, well, you've spoken. Let me get someone. I'll come back to you unless someone has spoken here.
That's all I
My name is Brent Scooter-Hilton, I'm an arts director. Looking at I just had a little synopsis, and then Samira also gave us a breakdown of how the whole thing is going to look like. Talking from an artistic point of view, or from an art point of view, I can perceive that there will be a lot going on in this film. Talking of glamorous cars, houses, locations, you know, and I want to ask, how prepared are we? Looking at the trend in filmmaking now, the trend has changed for the first, and have we really prepared, talking of pre-production, have we secured all our props and locations? And that's what I want to know, because if I'm working on this project, I need to work to make my name too as well.
$1,000. You want to know how much you can buy money? Some other position. Are you doing somewhere?
So if you are talking about logistics, if you are talking about locations, I have been on location for over a year on this job. I have gotten 99% of my locations for it. If you know somewhere, you know I think locations for every producer. And so if it's mine, then you should know what it's going to be like. Props. I have started before calling you. I've already looked for my props. I have done so much about the props. Even as of yesterday, that was a holiday. At 6 a.m., I was waiting somewhere looking at out for your props. So don't worry, most things are already in place. I have most of the props. My sister here, she has hot teas. She does most of the printing, the props, the t-shirts, the whatever that's in there. She's doing for me. She's sitting here sad. So a lot of things is already in place. Don't worry. When it comes to Sami's media, Nigeria. We are a full empire. Is that what they say? A full house, a big family. Everybody's in it, and we are working together.